We had to do investigations that were directly correlated to the most recent Freeh Report. Him and I communicated on a regular basis.
That's the former deputy and now Cape Coral mayoral candidate. He says he was investigating allegations of corruption during his time as commander of internal affairs, but the sheriff's office says they knew nothing about the allegations. NBC2's Christina Mendez is digging deeper for answers into why there are two different stories.
The Lee County Sheriff's Office says they just recently became aware of these documents, which accuses one of their own in helping a drug dealer. LCSO says they weren't aware until recently.
On to our next question.
The Cape Coral mayoral debate was heating up as each candidate was asked about Sheriff Mike Scott endorsing Joe Caviello.
Yes, my opponent got the endorsement of Mr. Scott. However, when I was working there, I too got the endorsement of Mr. Scott.
Candidate and former deputy Mike Hollow was defending his ground when he took us back to his days within the department.
He left me in a position that was the most trusted position within the agency. I was the commander of internal affairs.
Hollow then brought up an audit paid for by the city of Fort Myers to look into corruption allegations within the police department. In February, the Freeh Report was released, but just 2 weeks ago, these heavily redacted pages of the report were uncovered, accusing a Lee County deputy of protecting a drug dealer and using a LCSO car to transport narcotics.
We had to do investigations that were directly correlated to the most recent Freeh Report. Him and I communicated on a regular basis.
The Lee County Sheriff's Office says we have recently been made aware of the release of redacted copies of Appendix A and Appendix B of the Freeh Report, and added LCSO declines to join former employee Mike Hollow in speculating as to the subject matter involved in what appears to be an ongoing federal investigation.
Right now, the United States Attorney's Office is investigating criminal intelligence information within Appendix A and B, but would not comment further unless someone is charged with a crime. Live in the control room, Christina Mendez, NBC2.